Good morning, children.
Good morning, ma'am.
Morning. How are you all?
Morning,
we are
ma'am.
Now New Year 2021. Hi. Yes. Do you remember what we were learning?
Yes.
Fraction.
Add and subtract. Like fractions. Add and subtract like fractions. So what is like fractions?
Fractions that have same denominator.
Means the number below that number up, number on the top is called numerator. Below that is denominator. So like fraction means fraction that has same denominator. So how you can add or subtract fractions? Like fractions, we will add only.
Numerators.
We will add only numerators and write the same denominator. Okay. So all the children, please mute your audio and take page 16 workbook. Page number 16. Yes, then tell me how many questions over?
Till 15.
15 over. Yes.
Yes.
Can you read question number 16?
In the given figure, you
use
addition to find the fraction represented by the
unshaded parts. Okay, so children, you can see one question number 16A, that star. And how? Which all colors are there? Yellow and?
Yellow and red.
Red color. So, we have to find out how many parts shaded, how many parts unshaded. Same question, page number 16. 16. So, children, same like question number 15. We are continuing question number 16. Okay. Question number 16 also same like question number 15. So, what we had to do? First step, total parts. Can you count and tell me how many parts are there? Count and tell how many parts. 10 parts. Very good.
Yes,
page number 16. Now, how many parts yellow? Yes,
three.
Children. Three. Three by total number. 3 by 10. And how many parts red color?
4 by 10.
Okay. So, we will write together, children. This is same question. Like our question number 15. So page part 2, page number 16. All of you please take out and mute your audio. And we will do question number 16A. Children, listen carefully. Question number 16B, you have to do alone. You have to do alone question number 16B. So, what is the first step? Total parts. Count and tell me. Total parts. How many total parts are there?
10.
So, we have to find out this here question number 15A and B also we have done the same steps. Total number of parts we had to write. Then fraction for yellow. Fraction for yellow color. Fraction for yellow. Yellow color. What is the fraction? How much parts is colored yellow?
4 by 10. 3 by 10.
3. Out of 10, 10 parts total, from that 10 parts, we have 3 yellow color parts, so 3 by 10. So fraction for red color, fraction for red color. Fraction for red. Tell me children, how many parts is colored red?
That's three double, ma'am.
Yes?
Three double.
What? Who was saying something? Did you say something?
4 by 10.
Are you looking at your book? Some distraction sound.
Please. Ma'am, that 8.2, 17, 18, 19, 20 that I did not get from WhatsApp.
Okay, okay. Now you will get it. Okay, send me personal message. Okay. Now please take page number 16.
Ma'am.
Okay. So children here, red color. How many? 4 by 10. Fraction for yellow color is 3 by 10. Fraction for red color is 4 by 10. Now we have to find out fraction for shaded. Shaded means you have to get yellow and red. Fraction for shaded parts. Any color, total how many parts it is colored? Shaded parts. So yellow color plus red color. 3 by 10 plus 4 by 10. What's the answer? Leon CL.
7 by 10.
3 plus 4 is 7 by 10. 7. And write down the same denominator. So children, denominators we will not add. We will write the same denominator, but we have to add only the numerators. 3 plus 4 is 7. Very good. Now we have to find out fraction for unshaded. Fraction for unshaded. Who can tell me how we can find out fraction for unshaded?
Ma'am, Tony again.
Yes.
10 by 10 minus 7.
Very good. 10 by 10. Why here it is 10 by 10? Because here the total number of parts is 10. So to find write the whole part, we have to write the numerator and denominator the same. So 10 by 10 minus how much part is shaded? That is 7 out of 10. So you will get how many parts unshaded. Very good. So children, like the same we have done in our question number 15. So here 10 minus 7 is what? 3. 3 by 10. 3 by 10. So here, children, I hope you have finished. Write it fast. Total number of parts we had to write. Then which all colors we have? Yellow color and red color. So fraction for yellow, 3 by 10. Fraction for red, 4 by 10. Now fraction for shaded. Shaded means you have to count how many yellow plus how many red. Yellow plus red, that is equal to 3 plus 4, 7 out of 10. 7 by 10. Now fraction for unshaded, how you'll get? Total number of parts, that is 10. 10 by 10 minus how much shaded? 10 minus 7 is 3, 3 by 10. So those who children finished, you can do now question number 16, B alone. Same like this, total parts equal to. Question number 16, B. Sahil, please send me the WhatsApp that question, question numbers, okay? To me in the personal. Okay, Sahil. Sahil. Okay. So, Aiden, tell me 16B. How will I start? 16B. How many total parts? 16B. Total parts. So children, we can do together. Those who have started, no problem. You can continue. Total parts. And which all colors are there? Total parts is 8. Okay. Here which all colors are there? Question number B. Fraction 4. Which color? Green and
orange.
So fraction for green color. How many green color are there out of 8?
2.
So we have to write 2 by 8. Fraction for green color. 2 by 8. Now which is the next color? Orange. So fraction for orange color. Fraction for orange. How many orange color, Ridhu? Count and tell me. Count and tell me. Yes. Okay. So the answer is 3 by 8. I will send the notes. 3 by 8. But you have to write it now. Children, we can do together. Yes, I can see Delna and Dolly is writing very neatly. Fraction for orange color is 3 by 8. So what's the next step? Fraction for shaded parts. Fraction.
I didn't finish it.
Shaded. So how many green color plus how many orange color? Fraction for shaded parts. Two by eight plus 3 by 8. What's answer?
I completed, Ridhu.
Very good. Tell me two by eight plus five by eight. Now what we had to find out? Fraction for unshaded parts. Fraction for unshaded. Unshaded parts, how you can find out? Here, which is the total?
8 divided by 8 minus 5 by 8. It is 3 by 8.
3 by 8. So, this is the final answer. Okay, I hope all of you got the answer. Here, fraction for shaded, you can add. Then, fraction for unshaded, you have to find out using subtraction.
So here,
finished. Very good. The total here, the whole number total, that is equal to 8 by 8. Why? Because the here the semicircle that is divided into 8 part. So the total means the full that is 8 by 8. Then from that take away all the shaded part, that is 5 by 8. So the answer will be 3 by 8. I hope all of you have finished.
Ma'am, finish.
Finished.
Ma'am, are you there?
All of you finished?
Yes.
15? No.
16 A and B. Okay. I will quickly I will show and then I will send the note. Those who joined late, okay, I will send it again in the WhatsApp. So look here, question number 16 A. Here, first step, what you have to write? Total parts, that is 10. Now, how many colors are there? Yellow and red. So yellow color, the fraction is 3 by 10. Then red color, how many? 4 by 10. Then total, fraction for shaded, 3 plus 4. 3 by 10 plus 4 by 10, you will get 7 by 10. Now, what is that fraction for unshaded? 10 by 10 minus 7 by 10, you will get 3 by 10. So, like that, question number 16B. Look here. Here, the total number of parts is 8. So, here the colors are green and orange. So green, how many colors are there? Two parts. Two green, only two parts. So 2 by 8 is the fraction for green color. And orange color, it is 3 by 8. Now next one is fraction for shaded parts. Shaded. 2 by 8 plus 3 by 8, which is equal to 5 by 8. So the total parts, that is equal to 5 by 8. The fraction for unshaded, how we'll find out? Total will be 8 minus 8. Then take away the shaded parts. Then you will get the unshaded. So what's the answer? 3 by 8. Finished. Algan?
No.
Who said no? Algan, can you read the next question number 17?
Rakesh ate 1/4.
Be louder. Be louder.
Lunch during recess and.
Okay, so children, those who have not finished, write it fast. Then, if you have any connection problems, problem, I will send the notes in the WhatsApp. Okay, Algan, be louder. Rakesh
is lunch on the way home. How much of the lunch did he eat in all? How much was left uneaten?
So children, Rakesh ate 1/4 of his lunch in the school or during recess time, and 1/4 he ate on the way home. Why he ate on the way home? Maybe like you people, when you go home, your mother will scold. Why you didn't eat your food? Why you make it balance? So this boy, while going home, he ate how much? 1/4. So how much he ate in all? Total how much part he ate? 1/4 plus 1/4. What's the answer?
2/4.
So 1/4 he ate during recess time. Another 1/4 he will eat while going home. So total how much part he has eaten? That is 2/4. Now we have to find out how much left uneaten. How you can find out left uneaten? The total 4/4 minus
yes.
How much ate? That is 2/4. Understood the question? Yes? Okay. So children, we have to write total quantity of food that was eaten by Rakesh. So we'll write together question number 17, page number 17. Page number 17, question number also 17. So Rakesh ate 1/4 while during recess time, then 1/4 while going home. So we can write total quantity of lunch. Children, we can write together total quantity of lunch. Total quantity of lunch eaten by Rakesh. Rakesh, 1/4 during recess time plus 1/4 while going home. So what's the answer? 1/4 plus 1/4? Yes, children, you have already said. What's the answer, Sahal?
2/4.
Don't write 2/8, okay? Because we will add only the numerators. Then write the same denominator. Okay, very good. Now, so we can write total quantity of lunch is 2/8. So, 2/8? No. What's the answer? 2/4. 4. Yeah.
4.
Don't add the denominators. Okay. So Rakesh.
Later.
So Rakesh ate. So Rakesh ate 2/4 of his lunch in all. Of his lunch. Lunch in all. Now we have to find out one more thing. How much left uneaten? Okay. So total quantity of lunch eaten by Rakesh is 1/4 plus 1/4. That is equal to 2/4. So Rakesh ate how much? 2/4. Now what we have to find out? Quantity of lunch left uneaten. Quantity of lunch. Quantity of lunch quantity of lunch left uneaten. Quantity of lunch left uneaten. What we have to do, Niranjan? Quantity of lunch left uneaten. How you can find out?
2 by 4
is the answer. But I want you to tell me how much you can, how you can get that answer.
4 by 4 minus.
Very good. 4 by 4 minus 2 by 4. Okay, very good. So 4 by 4 means that is the total amount of food, total quantity of food. Total quantity of food means here 4 parts. The denominator is 4. The whole we can write it as 4 by 4 minus how much he has eaten, 2 by 4. So what is 4 minus 2? That is equal to 2 by 4. So this is the answer. That is the amount, or that is the quantity left uneaten. So we can write the last sentence here. Therefore, therefore 2 by 4 of his lunch was 2 by 4 of his lunch, 2 by 4 of his lunch is left uneaten, is left uneaten. By 4 of his lunch uneaten. So children, how will get the total quantity of lunch eaten by Rakesh? 1 by 4 during recess, 1 by 4 while going home. So the total quantity that was eaten by Rakesh is 2 by 4. So we can write it as a sentence. So Rakesh ate 2 by 4 of his lunch in all. Then we have to find out how much quantity of this food is left uneaten. Quantity of lunch left uneaten, but how we can find out? 4 by 4, that is the total or full, minus 2 by 4. So that's the answer is 2 by 4. Now look at the last sentence that is written in black. You have to write like that. Therefore, 2 by 4 of his lunch is left uneaten. Finish, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Angelo. Can you read question number 18? Yes, children. Finished.
Samir
painted
1 by 3 of a
fence.
Vijay painted 1 by 3 of the fence. Next day, how much fence is left unpainted.
So children, Samir painted how much? 1 by 3. And Vijay painted how much? 1 by 3. So first step, we have to find out total. Children, write together. Total part of the fence painted. Total part of the fence. Total part of the fence painted. So how much that is total means you have to add Samir painted 1/3 plus Vijay painted 1/3. So what's the total Shabari? 1/3 plus 1/3. One by three plus 1/3. Shabari, total part of the fence painted.
Man, 2/3.
Very good. 2/3. So total part of the fence painted. That is painted by Samir and Vijay. Total amount that is painted is 2/3. Total quantity that is 2/3. Now what we have to part of the fence left unpainted. Part of the fence. Part of the fence left unpainted. Unpainted. How we can find out here? What will be the total? Here it is. What will be the total, children? Here. How many total parts? 3. So 3/3 from 3/3, that is the full, the whole, you have to take away how many parts painted? 3/3 minus 2/3. What's the answer? Yes? 3 minus 2. Yes, Ridhu?
1/3.
1/3. 3 minus 2, that is equal to 1/3. Therefore, children, we can write, therefore, therefore, 1/3 of the fence is, 1/3 of the fence is left unpainted, unpainted. So children, this is the question. We had to find out how much part of the fence is unpainted.
Finish, ma'am.
Okay, very good. So children, what is the first step? Total part of the fence painted. How we can find out? The part painted by Samir plus part painted by Vijay. So you'll get 2/3. 1/3 plus 1/3 is equal to 2/3. Now part fence left unpainted, how you can find out? The total is 3/3. You have to take away 2/3. The answer is 1/3. So therefore, 1/3 of the fence is left unpainted. Okay, so children, I hope you have completed. I will send the notes, okay? So children, all these questions, 14 and 15, everything what we are doing, we are the same steps. Total number of parts, how much shaded, how much unshaded. So those who have finished.
Thank you.
Okay, so we'll wind up the class. Any problem, those who are not finished, I will send the notes in the WhatsApp. Okay, I will send in the WhatsApp. Okay, children, bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.